This video covers a week-long server battle with a Korean Zerg on a 100% vanilla Elver server. Now, I'm not gonna lie, it does start out pretty slow. The first few minutes are gonna be boring monologues, but it is critical in understanding the complexity of this story. And once you get through that, the action picks up, and oh man, does it pick up quickly. So without further ado, I present to you the Second Korean War. The path for this wipe was as follows. Build near the military base, acquire a helicopter and tank, complete some horde beacons, and kill a few stragglers along the way. Due to the immense mental and physical capabilities of my team and me, we were able to remain uncontested in nearly every situation. Every gunfight we won, every megazombie we killed, and every airdrop we recovered. Uninhibited by anything, we progressed exponentially. Every hour, our walls became thicker and the loot held within would multiply. We were aware of our elevated position. To merely wander and mercilessly execute every player that crossed our paths would be foolish, because repeatedly decimating nakeds impedes their progress and would make them quit the server. The American buffalo was nearly hunted to extinction in the 19th century. We would not repeat history. We treated the players of this server as a harvestable resource. We let them graze the land. They roamed the map with unbridled freedom. They killed zombies, collected loot, gathered resources, and built their bases all without the fear of a hit squad, six men strong, nullifying any progress they might have made. As the days passed, bases sprouted across the landscape like mushrooms on mycelium on a dewy Monday morning. From wooden 2x2s to two-story metal honeycombs, the bases were finally ripe for raiding. Our pacifism amplified our thirst for blood, and we were ready to go on the hunt.
Door. Yeah, shoot the door.
Boom. Spectre, yeah. No, fucking crawling shit.
You're still...
Oh, he's talking. He's dead.
There's a guy behind. I don't have ammo for this fucking...
Three mesh? Holy shit.
Guy.
Oh my god.
Fire in the hole. Oh yeah. We plundered every single formidable base on the server. When the multitude of teams, each consisting of 2 to 4 players, learned of their base's demise, they quit. Every single squad that quit was one less group for us to engage, to achieve victory over. Every single squad that had the potential to rival us, left. In their absence, we felt empty. There was nothing to do. No one that was worth killing. No bases worth raiding. Boredom settled in. Now what do you do when you have everything? A 20-story behemoth of a base, enough gear to arm Rhodesia, and completion of every questline? Well, you snipe defenseless nakeds from the top of your Burj Khalifa. After 20 minutes of readjusting the amygdalas of everyone within 500 meters of my base, I decided to hit up the town for some action. Oh. I was getting clapped up, so I told Splice to get on and cover me. As I was running back to base, shrieks of terror echoed through the Discord.
They're leaving. Oh my god, I wish I had a heat wave.
While I was in the town skirmishing with hordes of insurgents, getting my cheeks clapped, the Koreans landed on top of my base because they heard some scumbag was camping up there with a sniper. They patiently waited and killed the first person that climbed through the hatch, and that person happened to be Splice. Splice's death was tragic, ironically and unironically. You see, Splice had just logged in. Splice had forgotten to deposit the 6 missiles, 15 gunpowder, and 1,000 rounds of Hi-Cal he had on himself. Splice died, and now the Koreans had enough munitions to blow a sizable hole in our base. If they were lucky and reached our battery, they had the potential of clearing us. We had to act fast. We knew their base couldn't be too hard to raid, and if we could reclaim the munitions we had just lost, we would be able to rest easy knowing our base was safe for the night. We geared up and headed out, going in the same direction they had gone when they flew away.
Luckily, I think they are in a valley.
Take note on how I forgot the turret for this sentry. Fuck, I forgot the turret.
Wait, where's the sentry though? Oh, my cots.
Ten minutes have passed. The raid is over. We're about to leave. I hear the faint droning of a motorcycle in the distance.
I died. Fuck.
I didn't know they were that fucking butt close to you, bro.
I respawned close, and I managed to bypass their detection. All I needed to do was pick up a gun and kill them. I had an extreme element of surprise. Would this final desperate attempt at redemption pay off?
They don't see me. They don't see me, dude.
Oh,
What the fuck?
Not gonna lie, I feel like those first two shots should have resulted in two kills, but it seems the RNG gods had greater things in store for me. Oh, and by the way, if I hadn't forgotten the sentry turret, it would have killed all of them when they initially bum-rushed me. But I wasn't done there. I grabbed a pandiculator, a perfectly balanced automatic shotgun, and I went hunting. I wanted to exact revenge on these people that took so much from us. I scorched the earth with the blood of unsuspecting wanderers, my vision blinded, my sight polarized. Everything that moved must be destroyed. Countless fell to my wrath, but none of them were of those that took so much from us. We left the server with an unfamiliar taste of defeat. The bodies of the innocent populate the streets of the Elver. No justice had been delivered. A day passes. Upon joining the server, I immediately noticed distress calls from my neighbors. The Koreans are laying siege to their unfinished base and are in desperate need of a savior. Seeing an opportunity to harm my mortal enemies, I grab a shotgun and stealthily approach. Luckily, only two remained and they were not heavily geared. The defenseless inhabitants of the base thanked me for ridding them of their problem, but deep down, we both knew this solution was only temporary. They would inevitably return, with greater numbers and much more firepower. We knew we had to incinerate the neck of this Hydra before it overcame us. The Koreans had built a new base somewhere on the map, but its whereabouts remained an enigma. We heard whispers of possible locations, but none were absolute. Our only choice was to destroy every single base on the server. This not only increased our chances of successfully destroying the Koreans' base, but also removed possible raid loot from the Koreans' hands if they were to raid these bases instead. So me and the boys loaded up our chariot of divine justice and departed on the second exodus.
I cannot wait.
Bingo!
Just Baba-booey!
Let's go, middleman!
Oh my god. Oh my, there's so many radios.
Oh, Devastator on the floor. Hell yes, baby. I'm just gonna scrap everything.
Scrap.
Oh, we don't need that. Wait, is there even a claim thing here?
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Respirator, full respirator. Let's go. It's a me.
Let me inside.
Anything in there?
It's open.
Beds!
Yeah, but use your drill, god fucking damn it. Fucking I please, I don't want the Koreans to come and
you
lose
think
another
I give
fucking
a
thousand
I don't
rounds.
Care.
Garbage, dude. Shoot this doorway.
Fucking it's nothing.
What a shitty bait.
Get ready! Hey, fire! Miska, Muska!
Holy mother.
Drill!
Don't
get
all
distracted.
Drop everything. Take all this metal and scrap everything. There were some thick sets in here, so...
Can you not be in the driver, Dabba?
No, he's in the driver's... He's third person, so we can see everything. Dabba, keep watch. Make sure this Asian doesn't come here. Because he's good. He can kill all of us!
All of us!
And one swift mag.
But he's never seen what the Dabba do.
Filthy.
They're Koreans.
Boys, can I start raging without paranoia?
Of all the bases, none were lootacious enough to be owned by the Koreans, which baffled us. We raided every large base on the server and they were all duds. Where were the Koreans hiding all of their loot? We went to sleep that night, mystified and anxious at the fact that we have not stifled their progress at all. A day passes. I was out gathering metal to fortify my base when I noticed some movement on the horizon. I investigated and realized it was the Koreans. Three of them. Fully geared, maxed out to the gills. As a precautionary move, I sprinted to the safe confines of my tank and called for backup. But they had me surrounded, and I was on the other side of the map. It would take minutes before reinforcements arrived. Would I survive until then? Throw grenades!
Are you using the tank?
They're not gonna blow up the tank.
Yes, they will. Trust me, they already done it once.
Ow. They keep throwing grenades. How many grenades did you have on you? They have so many.
Coming with a shotgun. Don't know if it's gonna...
They're around my tank, dude.
Where you... Oh.
I killed one! He was trying to be inside the tank! He had so much shit on him, oh my god.
I'm near a construction site right now. I'm coming to you.
I killed two! They keep coming in here!
Yes! Into the tank?
They keep trying to fucking, like, glitch inside. And I keep shooting the entrance. Killed two. They had full thick gear. Oh, one's back here.
boat section.
He's bleeding.
Ow.
They flashed me, bro. They fucking flashed me, bro. What?
Did you kill him?
Killed him.
Nice.
Not the smartest moves were made by them, but we came out victorious with plenty of loot to satisfy. They had over 30 grenades, 1,500 rounds of ammo, and multiple thick sets on each of them. Why were they carrying around so much loot? Do they even have a base? Were they roaming around the map with all of their progress? This encounter created more questions than it answered. A day passes. I joined the server and experienced deja vu. My neighbors are under siege by the Koreans and are in desperate need of assistance again. In my mind, I was indestructible. I had a tank, and the base was situated in a relatively open area. All I had to do was get a few roadkills, curb their aggression, and force them to retreat. What could go wrong? After running them over for a bit, they quickly switched their focus to me. I returned back to base, and they followed. This is when I realized I might have fucked up. I'm low on gas, there are six of them, one of me, they have a vehicle, and the sentry in front of my base in the tree isn't working. If my Devastator was devastating as it should've, none of what is about to happen would have happened. They tried blocking me from parking my tank in the garage. It seemed they were waiting for my tank to run out of fuel. Still though, I didn't know what their endgame was. I doubt they had a steely wheelie, and even if they did steal it, it was out of gas so it couldn't go anywhere. I was genuinely confused until...
Yep, that's right. All you need is a car jack, some experience, and you can fling a 27-ton tank 100 meters at a time. It was late for me, so I logged off taking a big L. They had a tank, an active six-man, and at least 12 hours before I would log on again. Would my base be in ruins when I returned in the morning?
A four-man Korean fire team blew through the western wall of my fortress. Luckily for us, they only got to the loot of our most inactive teammate, and just as they were blowing to Taco's room, a very valuable room, I showed up. I mean, come on. Our entire team is offline for 12 hours, and they decided to start raiding 5 minutes before I get on. They outnumbered me 4-1. They could have easily overpowered me and continued raiding, but because of external support from my neighbors, the same people who I defended twice from the Koreans, they were not able to do that. They heard my base being raided, and they arrived to defend. Helping them in the past, acquiring these allies proved to be worthwhile. If it wasn't for them, the Koreans would have tunneled through my entire base, destroying every locker along the way. And for that, I'm grateful. Splice got on. We knew they were low on resources, crippled mentally and physically from a failed base raid attempt. The Koreans would be easy to pick off, so we pursued them as they fled our base.
Yeah, I see him. He is thick. Got him. One down.
One
There's more.
We're close.
Ow. Hit me.
Killed healing, another. Healing. Killing, there's one
zombie,
more.
Zombie,
it's the
zombie.
Guy ahead.
Northwest. Let's push him together.
It's a four man. Oh, I gotta go back, I gotta run back.
Kill
I
one,
gotta
kill
go
one.
Downhill. His last one.
Last one's low. He's lit. He's down. He's down. Yo, let's go.
Based on their movements, paired with my supernatural geographical deduction skills and the fact that someone literally told me exactly where the Koreans' base is, me and the boys went to investigate, and what we found was not nearly what we were expecting.
This is how to think. Yeah, get out. We gotta inspect this place.
What does it say right here? How to think.
Oh, this base is well guarded. Alright, this is definitely Chinese if I saw one.
Chinese!
Or Korean! Okay, so this is like an outer wall, man. Colors. You'll see.
Do you get...
Yeah. Oh, you're dead.
Fucking bitch, dude.
Come here.
What the hell?
This way.
Yeah, I know. This is a Korean base, 100%. I think this is loot right here.
This base is unnecessarily huge. While we were surveying their base, the Koreans began to log in. Escape became our main priority. We had to get the hell out of here because if they all got on, none of us were going to survive. What is this base? This is going to be so fun to raid. Oh my god. Oh, go right there,
I killed him. Fucking, you guys aren't helping.
What do you mean? We distracted him.
He was aiming at me the whole time, man.
We were distracting him. We have finally found the Koreans' base. Previously, our enemy had Lovecraftian status. From the shadows, innumerable bodies of malicious intent would appear, laying waste to the nature of man. From whence they came, unknown, and where they went, only supposed. But now they had a concrete and distinct headquarters, a headquarters which we could obliterate, a physical location which after annihilation would allow us to know that we were victorious. We had the necessary explosives and high count to Beirut their base. All we had to do was map out and execute a plan. First, we formed an alliance with former enemies whose base was within sniper's distance of the Koreans. We supplied them with the most powerful bolt-action rifles in the game along with 300 bullets. These three men would stay on their base, sniping off any exposed Koreans while simultaneously giving us information on the positions and movements. Our only method of penetrating the many layers of honeycomb would be to brute force through the walls, to conceptually drill a hole all the way from the exterior to the center with our light machine guns, forming a path for our tank so that it could fire directly into the base's core. We set out on this campaign of indisputable rectitude to eradicate this enemy and banish any concomitant ideologies. This infestation, this plague, this scourge of malice and rancor has blighted the fragile sanctity of peace that has prevailed for millennia. It is our civic duty as citizens of the United States of America, proprietors of the most objectively conscientious and virtuous piece of literature conceivable, to put forth above all else the annihilation of this Leviathan. So, brothers and sisters, bear witness the consummation of a week-long crusade.
Hey, let me know if you need a...
Killed one.
Everybody, stay in the fucking tank. Do not leave the tank.
Menno, there's no one else on this, like, thing. You have two ladders?
I'll drop you a ladder.
Yeah, drop it, yeah.
This guy up there.
Yeah.
Shoot the two metal walls. Second from the right. Yeah, shoot them. Lit one. Top guy's lit.
Yeah, he's running.
He's dead.
Nice.
Dead.
Okay, I'm gonna place ladders.
Someone on the top right of their base. On their top part
right.
Of the base.
Yeah. Nice.
Guy there. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I got some. They have sentries.
Liberator, focus the kid on the body.
On the body?
There's one guy above you guys.
Okay, you didn't have to push like that.
That's fine.
I'm reloading.
Alright, we're in.
Get in the tank.
Okay, nice. He's dipping.
Shoot it towards that honeycomb.
I hit him on the roof once. Dude, I'm trying to
minimize. You're fucking whiffing, dude.
I'm not whiffing now, like, I'm literally.
Wizard kid, I don't see him. I see him.
Watch out for the sentry.
I know where the sentry is.
Shoot this metal thing on the left. Shoot the metal one on the left.
I'm getting kind of low, but...
Dabba, shoot that metal wall.
I have boxes.
Dabba just fucking died.
Yeah.
If you guys come here, it'll be a clusterfuck.
Yeah, Caleb.
Make sure you shoot the... Alright, there you go. I don't have any high cow on. Check Dabba's body. Spectre, did you pick up all that high cow? Spectre, come back. Don't fucking dive the high cow. Oh my, he's up there. Monkey's up. He's up there.
I hit Sean, he's dead. I got him.
They're all inside their base, right?
Take this high cow.
Yeah, we're just
watching. Give it to monkey. Taco,
yeah.
Get this loot.
Yeah.
Yo, someone destroy that sentry.
Oh, it's okay.
Get that sentry.
I'm gonna shoot the sentry, don't worry about it.
I'm shooting it too.
Front door!
I'm dead, I'm so dead. Oh,
nice.
Thank you so much.
Get his loot.
On the roof.
I hit him.
He fell.
I'm gonna try and get the tank in here. Monkey, come to me. Destroy that wooden base.
Well, a splint.
I'm dropping one right now.
Tank's coming in.
I got a big brain.
Who has the TV?
Shoot that right there. That one, second floor.
Who's loot is this over here?
Con's right next
to us. Mine.
Oh yeah, shoot another one. Shoot one of those metal walls.
Here, splash.
Give down
on the roof. On the roof.
Splash the roof. Yeah.
On the roof.
Yeah.
He fell.
He dropped.
Yeah. Why are you inside? Splash, right?
On the roof. On the roof.
I broke it. Shoot it. There's a guy there.
Shoot a wall.
Yeah,
shoot
he salvaged the wall.
Which wall?
He salvaged the wall. Watch out. On top.
Shoot another.
He's on.
No. What the fuck?
Oh, no. I killed one.
Good shit.
Hey, look, a tank.
Splice, come get the high cal.
Oh my.
Oh. Fucking destroy their base. Straight up core.
Oh.
That's unfortunate.
Hello.
Tank shells are done.
I'm gonna put turret lines.
I'm gonna on top of the base.
Okay, now we've destroyed most of their beds, they'll be running
front.
That's what we're talking about. Yeah, we're gonna watch.
Who's the guy in the right gear? Oh,
there's so much stuff here. Run roof.
Oh, he's in this room.
Outside the front door. Front door. I can't hit him, bro.
So loud. Our initial Normandy-like breach was a success. I went back to base, got like 6 heat waves, like 2,000 rounds of ammo, and it was time to start tunneling through their base. Oh, and if you're wondering, this base raid is far from over. Shit starts getting wacky.
He died.
I'm gonna get us a ladder.
What are they playing in there?
I'd say let's go through this wall right here.
I hear Jen.
Yeah. I hear the generator.
Alright, people, okay, don't get in the way of
people. Yeah, yeah, if you're not heat waving, don't.
Alright, are we doing the one under the ladder?
Yeah. That
shit,
one.
Wait,
okay. Ready, boys?
I have grenades. Yeah. I'm gonna throw grenades down there.
Wait, which one are we shooting?
Alright, the one under the ladder.
There. Really?
No. Stop. You're shooting the wrong one. The farther one. Shoot the farther one. That's the one under the ladder.
Oh, they took. We already got it.
I fell in, boys.
Grenade!
Oh my god.
I fell in and broke my legs.
Which one?
We're idiots.
I smack.
What the hell is that?
Yeah, I just saw him.
This one?
He's in that one by one. This one I'm gonna shoot at.
Oh, that
one?
Right.
Yeah,
that
he's
one?
Alright.
Oh, that one's damaged to me.
Alright. I'm gonna load back.
So far.
I killed him.
You just killed Khan.
You guys win.
Full base salvage. Full base salvage, and we go.
Oh my god!
Oh,
man.
I can't hear
you. Oh,
grenades!
Grenades! Find us!
Oh no! Metal, you killed all of us!
Metal, man, you blew me up, Metal.
Hey, Chinese, go away! Monochrome is Chinese! Chinese! Come on, Chinese, you dumb fuck! You're the Chinese! No, Chinese, Chi Chang Chong, yeah! Your life's in, motherfucker! Yeah, man!
Grenade!
Why'd you throw that in, bro?
I killed someone.
I'm Yellow Monk. I'm Mana Monk.
Oh my god.
I want banana and chocolate.
There should be ladders on the floor, and there's one on my body to your right.
There's so much stuff here.
He's in here. They're in here.
Banana.
Should we just spray the wall with the doggo?
Let's wait for people.
Great again.
Blueberry, do you have pendiculator?
No, I don't! I wish I did. Ow! What was that?
He just killed me. He's in one of the one by ones.
I died too.
I think that was him.
I think that was the last guy.
Yeah. Because
Stop dropping stuff on the ground.
No! Okay, you're a liar.
I promise. I'm not a liar. I swear.
Okay.
He's about to open the door. Watch.
Wait a second.
My hands are up. There's I swear on my mom's life. My hands are up. I promise.
Okay.
Imagine you're not going to
I promise. All he placed the in my hands. I have to surrender. My hands are up. Both of my hands are to the sky.
I know.
And we go.
I'm really this house.
Believe me.
Help! As I'm beating up this house. Help!
That was whole base. And we go.
I'll show you my arms.
Help!
These are my arms.
Help!
My arms are up.
No, I'm stuck here. No, I'm not beating this house.
Look. Open the door. I come inside and then you close the door. All right. I just want to talk.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay. All right, just open the door. I'm going to come inside and then you close
the door. We're going to get the doorway.
Here are my hands. Open the door. Look, these are my hands. You see them through the wall? I have no guns.
Okay, listen close. Listen close. Okay, last chance. Salvage the base and we go. Okay? Last chance. Yes or no? Yeah or no?
Hold
base and we go.
Your friend is to open the door.
Hey,
your friend opens the door, then I'll think about it.
Okay.
Hey, you didn't open the door. This is what you're gonna get.
Hold it.
Got him.
They're
on
him.
No, they're under.
He's under.
Oh, yeah.
He's right here. He's right here. He's right here. He's right here.
I'm trust you, I'm calling this flyer, I'm your YouTube subscriber. Why did you lie to me?
One of y'all help
me. Right here. Dead. I'm dead.
Oh no!
Help! Why did you kill us?
My friend
Dominic.
Oh! Old game?
Oh, this is...
Sorry, that was a con flame.
I think some of this is mine.
Error!
Got him.
He's spawning, so gotta do it quick.
It was a good run, boys.
Who the fuck's got their recorder from like 5th grade, okay?
Yeah, wait, I think
he's down there, don't fall.
He's dead.
He's stuck down there?
Yeah, he got stuck down there and I just bopped him.
We had fun memeing around, but it was time to get back to business. I go to the safe zone and spend all my money on military radios so that I can make over 20 tank shells. An absolute guarantee for their base, the end is near.
Here, Mano, I want to show you what wall you need if you're going to
attack.
Whoa. Hey, you're shooting the fresh floor.
Oh my goodness.
Doesn't matter, I guess. You're literally going to take out the whole base.
Nope.
Alright.
Oh my
god. Keep shooting.
You made it out faster.
You know salvage base, we salvage base.
115 base.
There? Yeah.
Yep, perfect. Letter with... Oh, you see him?
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god!
There's one more.
Oh my...
Oh, he's right here.
Dude, Savage Base, man.
Yeah, I got the word beat.
I'll see you live.
I'll help you.
Pick up the check. I'm gonna see if you're fucking...
There's Maple Lockers. It's like right above.
Oh my god.
That room.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that room on the left.
Load up.
Yeah, there now, bro. Oh yeah, there we go.
One more.
Yeah, one more.
One more. Everyone back away.
Still more. What?
Oh my god. Taco. Alright, we're good.
Okay, you're good.
I even died.
Oh gosh. So much thick gear.
Someone translate this sign.
As I stand here in the ruins of this Korean citadel, I think of the week leading up to this exact moment. We started out as an unconquerable force. Our inflated egos blinded us to the possibility of defeat. Because of our high, deluded self-image of grandeur, our fall down, our humbling by the Koreans was amplified. They gave us exactly what we wanted. A challenge. This victory would be nothing if it weren't for the tragic losses we suffered and the sheer difficulty of this venture. As we return to base, the Koreans were waiting for us, seated at a campfire, eager to tell their side of the story, and we were eager to listen. Thank you, Korean Zerg, for the most fun I've ever had in my return.